Good morning, Rechavia Nachlaot, Erev Shabbat Kodesh, Erev Shabbat Shalom. Good morning, everyone, and it is a great honor to be able to share with all of you a Kabbalah Cafe, our first for this year of Tafshin Pei, 5780-2020. Bezrat Hashem, anachnu nilmad biyachad nekuda shekashur laparashiyot shalanu, ve אנחנו גם נתעורר ביחד ונאכל ונשתה כל אחד במקומו. Each and every one of us, please take some coffee. My tea is coming soon, and tea is okay too. And we'll be able to hopefully have a little farbrengen, online farbrengen. I pray to Hashem that Hashem takes away this terrible virus from the entire world very, very soon. And Bezrat Hashem will be able to once again have our Kabbalah cafe at a real cafe. Together, that's a real for bringing. L'chaim, l'chaim. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech haolam, shehakol nehiya bedvaro. All the doors. Okay, Yofi, welcome. So the best thing to, we're going to talk today about being holy, which is the underlining thread from these two parshas. This week, tomorrow we're going to read, I guess at home, or with a Torah, or with a Chumash, Achrei Mot and Kedoshim. And we're going to try to tie it into the time now in which we find ourselves with the terrible illness of the corona, and hopefully we'll see what it means really to be holy. Ani rotze la'azkir she Reb Eli v'Jacqueline Yaffe tarmu et ha'shiur hazeh l'zchut refuah shleima shel Moshe ben Gazet v'gam le'ilui nishmat Benny Wolf mehanover. Mr. and Mrs. Ellie and Jacqueline Jaffe dedicated this special class in the Refuah Shleima for Moshe Ben Gazet, and also in the memory of the Shliach that passed away this past Shabbat evening, Rabbi Benny Wolf, the Shliach of Hanover, Germany. Gam b'parashat Achrei Mot v'gam b'parashat Kedoshim medabrim al yot kadosh. Both in these parshas, we talk about being holy. In Achrei Mot, we talk about Yom Kippur, the holiest day of the year. We also talk about the two sons of Aaron HaKohen, which unfortunately passed away. Achrei Mot Shnei Bnei Aaron. Why did they pass away? They passed away because they wanted to be holy. So what did they do? They went into the Holy of Holies. They were not allowed to go in there. And they acted to be holy. But the problem was that they were not allowed to be there. And so therefore, being holy in that way is not the way Hashem wants it to be. Holy might be nice, but if it's not in the context of the way Hashem set up the world, then that's not a good holiness, quote-unquote. And then we talk about the different relationships that are not allowed. Because Am Yisrael has to be Kedoshim. As the Taparsha finishes off, V'hiyitem Kedoshim, we need to be holy. Eretz Yisrael is a holy place. V'lo taki etchem ha'aretz, Eretz Yisrael will not spit us out. Because Eretz Yisrael is a holy place. We need to maintain the holiness. Obviously in the second Parsha, Parshat Kedoshim, that's for sure talking about being holy. That's the name of the Parsha. V'hiyitem Kedoshim, Hashem tells us, we should be holy. Ki kadosh ani, because I am holy too. In other words, we have to be like Hashem. And soon I'm going to take one mitzvah of the many mitzvahs of Parashat Kedoshim, and I'm going to show you how it's possible to be really holy. B'shnei ha-parashiyot medubar ech liyot kadosh. Gam medubar ba'achrimot al liyot kadosh yom ha-kippurim. Ech kol achat tzarech liyot kadosh. V'gam b'kedoshim, avo mazel liyot kadosh. איך אנחנו יכולים באמת להיות קדושים? זה נשמע משהו ככה קדוש, איך חלילה להבדיל להיות בתאילנד, מזרח הרחוק, ולנסות כל מיני חלילה. זה נקרא קדוש?
לא.
מה שנקרא קדוש, זה מה שהקדוש ברוך הוא קובע. It's only Hashem who defines for us what it means to be really holy. So what does it mean? Not everything we choose, not every idea that comes up in our minds, that really makes us holy. What decides for us, what defines holiness, is what HaKadosh Baruch Hu defines for us. Ze ma HaKadosh Baruch Hu machlit. So we're going to take one mitzvah. There are many mitzvahs in Parashat Kedoshim. We're going to take one mitzvah, and we're going to try to figure out what does it mean to be holy? Ha-mitzvah hachi ha-ahuva alai ze mitzvat v'ahavta l'reacha kamocha ani Hashem. Zat omeret she-te-ohav et ha-chaver v'akadosh baruch hu ani, omer ani Hashem. Ha-mitzvah ha-zot shel v'ahavta l'reacha kamocha ze mitzvah שיכול להתפרש בכמה דרכים. המצווה הזאת היא מצווה מאוד מאוד קשה לקיום. אבל אם אנחנו נזכור איך לקיים את המצווה הזאת, אז אנחנו נזכה להיות קדוש באמת. קדוש זה לא רק למות על קידוש השם. קדוש זה לחיות בקדושה. זה דרגה הרבה יותר נעלית מאשר חלילה רק למות על קידוש השם. ומיד אחרי זה כתוב, אני השם. כן, אני השם, הקדוש ברוך הוא אומר לנו, אם תעשה ואהבת לריך כמוך, כמו שצריך, כמו שאני אומר, כמו שאני קובע, אז אתם תצליחו באמת להיות קדושים. One mitzvah, which is perhaps the underlining mitzvah of the entire Torah, ואהבת לריך כמוך, love your fellow Jew just as yourself. It sounds like a very nice hip-hop mitzvah. Very cool. Love you, love everyone. Bring love to the world. Bring light to the world. But very often, this mitzvah is very hard to fulfill. Very difficult. And this mitzvah of Yahavta L'Reacha Kamocha, if we will observe it properly, then we will have the zechut of fulfilling Hashem's mitzvah and bringing Kedusha to the world. But if we do v'ahavta l'recha kamocha the way I want, not looking at the two words right after the v'ahavta l'recha kamocha, ani Hashem. Yes, HaKadosh Baruch Hu tells us, I am God. What does he have to say right after v'ahavta l'recha kamocha, I am Hashem? Doesn't say that after many other of the mitzvahs. I am Hashem. Of course, we know you are Hashem. Thank you very much. Why does Hashem have to write ani Hashem? It seems to be that this mitzvah, v'ahavta l'recha kamocha, is very difficult. And when we will put in the Ani Hashem into it, when we'll put in I am Hashem, then we will realize that this mitzvah is so important, and we will do our best, then we will fulfill the mitzvah properly. V'ahavta l'recha kamocha. How is it possible to fulfill this mitzvah? To love Hashem, kamocha, just as yourself, bidyu kamocha. הרי אנחנו אוהבים את עצמנו אהבה עצמית. ככה השם ברא אותנו. אנחנו בני אדם, ואנחנו אוהבים את עצמנו בלי גבול, בלי סוף. אין הגבלה, אין תיאור לכמה שכל אחד אוהב את עצמו. אנחנו נשמור על עצמנו, אנחנו לא ניתן לאף אחד לעשות כלום, כי אנחנו, ככה השם ברא אותנו. אפילו חלילה אם אנחנו ניפול, אז מיד היד והמרפק תופס אותנו ושומר על הראש. ככה השם ברא אותנו. אז איך אפשר לקיים את המצווה הזאת? This mitzvah seems to be a very, very difficult mitzvah. To love your fellow Jew kamocha, just as yourself, that's a very difficult task. How is it possible to love another person as yourself? We don't love anyone like we love ourselves, just by definition. Kamocha, we love ourselves. That's how HaKadosh Baruch Hu created us. He created us in a way that we should love ourselves to no end, to no limitation. That's just how we are. And so if so, it seems to be a very difficult mitzvah to fulfill, v'ahavta l'recha kamocha. And the answer is, how do we fulfill the mitzvah? By looking at the next two words, Ani Hashem. I am God. Kishemistaklim al milim Ani Hashem, ma mitbarer? Sheyesh kan shutaf shlishi. Ken, lo rak ata v'ani, at v'ani. Yesh kan HaKadosh Baruch Hu be'emtza. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, hu shutaf shlishi. Ve'az efshar la'asot ahavat Yisrael kamo shetzarech. כי אם אנחנו מסתכלים על יהודי השני ולא אוהבים אותו מצד הדברים הטובים שיש לו, החוכמה שלו, העשירות שלו, היופי שלו, אלא מצד זה שיש לו נשמה, שהוא חלק אלוקה ממעל, אז יש לנו תמונה שונה על יהודי. אז יש לנו אפשרות לפותח את האפשרויות שנוכל באמת לאהוב אחד את השני כמו שצריך. Usually, one person loves another person for something special that they did. Either you did a favor for me, wow, I appreciate it so much. Or you have a lot of money, or you're very wise, or you have wonderful midot, wonderful emotions, or you have different reasons why a person can love another person. But when it comes to this mitzvah, the mitzvah is v'ahavta l'recha kamocha, because Ani Hashem, because I am God. You see, we have three partners to this love. There's you and I, and then there's a third partner. That's Ani Hashem. I am God. Why do we love another person? Because we train ourselves to differentiate between the individual and his deeds. It could be someone had offended us. It could be someone did not fulfill the mitzvah the way it's supposed to be done. That's not a reason, God forbid, for us to hate them. Hate is out of the question. We're never allowed to hate another person, because we have to focus on the essence, on the Ani Hashem, on I am God. And if we realize that this is the central theme of the love, then it's possible to be Ani Hashem. So, a person might want to say, without the Ani Hashem, Ulai Mishu Yagid, Ani Rotze Liyot Kadosh, Ani Rotze Lasot Varim Yuchadim, Vani Rotze Livchor Laatzmi, Et Mi Ani Ohev, Ve Et Mi Ani Lo Ohev, Ve'im Mishu Pagabi, אז אני לא אוהב אותו. אני רוצה להיות, לעשות דברים טובים ולהזמין אנשים, אבל רק במסגרת שלי. אני אחליט. אומר הקדוש ברוך הוא, אני השם. רק השם יחליט. רק הקדוש ברוך הוא בעצמו, הוא זה שמחליט איך צריך לקיים את המצוות. וזה הסוד של ההצלחה של קיום המצווה של ואהבת לרעך כמוך. A person might think that we can be holy and kadosh, and a person will look at themselves and say, I will make the decisions, I will decide how to fulfill the mitzvah, or who to invite to my home. But when we look at the concept of Ani Hashem, that I am God, the neshama, which is deep down inside of us, then we realize that we open our homes to everyone and to anyone. And this is the third component for Ani Hashem. And this is like the story of Eliezer, the great tzaddik, Eliezer and Sarah. They were very sick. They lived around 350 years ago. And Eliezer had a very successful business. And it was a big Talmud Chacham, a Torah scholar. And Eliezer would open up his house every Friday night, every Shabbat, to have many, many guests over. One time, one person walked in with his backpack, and he did not look at all Torah observant, and he looked poor, He looked ill, and he walked into the home. The home was, the table was filled with people and guests. And all of a sudden, people started looking at this individual that walked into the home. And they looked at him, and some people suggested that he should leave. Eliezer saw this individual walking in. He right away welcomed him with a smile. Please come into my home. He gave him a seat. Here's wine. Make Kiddush. Wash. He showed him how to read the Kiddush. People that were sitting there were shocked. Why is the host welcoming in such an individual? But Eliezer treated him like a mensch, treated him like a king, just like everyone else. After the meal, Eliezer accompanied him to the door, and the person told him, I am really Eliyahu Hanavi, and it is remarkable the way you've treated me, even though you probably thought, just like everyone else at the table, that I was this individual not to come close to. Because you have done this special act of Ahavat Yisrael, Achnasat Orchim, you are going to merit to have a son, because Eliezer and Sarah had not had children up until that point. And you are going to have a son who is going to light up the world. He's going to excel in Ahavat Yisrael. And that was the Baal Shem Tov, Rabbi Yisrael. Yisrael Baal Shem Tov. He was born to these two great parents, Yisrael, Eliezer and Sarah. And the Baal Shem Tov, this was his underlining mission in this world, to reveal Ahavat Yisrael. Tzar li lahagid, shebizman Baal Shem Tov, היו הרבה צדיקים, תלמידי חכמים, שלצערנו לא התחשבו באנשים פשוטים. וכשהם לא התחשבו באנשים פשוטים, הקדוש ברוך הוא הבין שהעולם נמצא במצב של אילפון, התעלפות. ועם ישראל לא יכול להמשיך במצב כזה. אם היו 9 תלמידי חכמים, ואחד אדם פשוט, הם לא היו מחשיבים אותו למניין, תאמינו או לא, אני לא מאמין שאני מוציא מהפה אפילו הסיפור הזה, הנקודה הזאת. אבל הקדוש ברוך הוא שלח נשמה טהורה שתחיה את עם ישראל, וזה הבעל שם טוב. השם נתן לו את השם ישראל, שזה השם של עם ישראל, ויש לו, הוא נתן לו את הכוח ואת אפשרות להחיות את עם ישראל. הוא היה מסתובב בין כל הכפרים, והוא היה נפגש עם אנשים פשוטים, והוא היה אמר להם, נו רב ינקל, רב מוישה, מה שלומכם? מה שלומך? והיו אומרים, ברוך השם. וואו, אמר הבעל שם טוב, איזה יופי, איך הקדוש ברוך הוא נהנה. הבעל שם טוב loved every single Jew, even people who did not seem to be part of the clan, so to speak. But nevertheless, the Baal Shem Tov would encourage everyone to say Baruch Hashem and to read the Tehillim. And this is the secret of Ani Hashem. The Baal Shem Tov taught us to be able to look deep down with a laser beam, deep down into the neshama. Kishanachnu osim focus ala Ani Hashem, ala ha-shutaf ha-shlishi, we put a focus on the third partner that we have, one Jew and another Jew and a Kadosh Baruch Hu. That rhymes. One Jew, and a Kadosh Baruch Hu, then we know that we have the proper Ahavat Yisrael. V'ze be'emet masbir, ech ze she'anachnu yicholim, she'nadav v'avihu, hayu kol kach kedoshim, b'tchilat parashat achrimot. Lama Kadosh Baruch Hu lakach otam? Lama Kadosh Baruch Hu lo kibel et ha'korban shelahem, et ha'esh, et ha'ktoret shelahem? לכאורה רצו להתקרב, עשו דבר טוב, כי הם עשו את זה על דעת עצמם. וזה לא ייתכן שבעם ישראל, בבית המקדש, במשכן, בחיים הקדושים שלנו, שאנחנו נחליט. אנחנו חייבים להסתכל כל הזמן איך הקדוש ברוך הוא קובע לנו מה זה קדושה. לא אנחנו שקובעים. This is the exact explanation for how is it that Hashem did not accept the offering from Nadav and Avihu, two sons of Aaron, b'korvatam l'fnei Hashem v'yamutu. Seemingly they did something so wonderful. They came into the Holy of Holies. They wanted to cleave onto Hashem. But what happened? Hashem said, no, I can't accept this sacrifice, this offering. I can't have everyone decide for themselves how to come closer to me. There needs to be an underlining point which decides for us, which this gives us the inspiration and the guideline of how we should come closer to Hashem. L'chaim. And we say Achshav l'sayim im Sipur. Unfortunately, this week, earlier this week, in other words, on Shabbat, this past Shabbat, a dear friend of mine, Rabbi Benny Wolf, passed away in Hanover. He was only 43 years old, and everyone was sure that he would be buried in Israel. Right after Shabbos, Rabbi Techtel, who is one of the chief shluchim in Germany, the head shliach of the Rebbe in Berlin, who he apparently was with Rabbi Wolf for the last few hours, he had arranged everything. Arranged a flight for the coffin of Rabbi Wolf and Rabbi Wolf's wife, Mrs. Wolf, and the children should come to Eretz Yisrael and should be buried in Eretz Yisrael. For over 75 years since the Shoah, since the Holocaust, no rabbi was buried in Germany. Lo haya shum rav me'az ha-Shoah שנקבר בגרמניה. עלי אדמות שנטבחו ונרצחו מיליוני יהודים. 6 million Jews were murdered because of the Germans in Germany and also outside of Germany. But Rabbi Benny Wolf was the first Rav that was buried in Germany. Why was that? Why was that? Why was he buried in Germany? And the answer is, because right after Shabbat, Rabbi Wolf's wife told Rabbi Techtel and the other shluchim, there is no way that Benny will be buried anywhere else but in the place of his shlichut. Rabbi Benny was a lively shliach. Rabbi Benny was a shliach who took care of the Jews in Hanover. When Rabbi Benny came to Hanover 15 years ago, he was not allowed into the shul. They did not know who he was. People did not want to have any connection with him, unfortunately. But the moment that they started to meet him, the moment that they got together with him, and they realized what kind of a wonderful neshama he was, across the board, that he became loved with all organizations in Hanover, and he became friends with everyone, not only a rabbi. People eulogized Rabbi Benny that he was simply a friend, not only with the locals, but also there's apparently a very big hospital, medical center in Hanover, which deals with a specific illness with a brain, God forbid, Hashem Yirachem. And a lot of people came from Israel to Hanover to be treated. And Rabbi Benny would welcome them and would take care of all of their needs. Mrs. Wolf said that Rabbi Benny is going to continue his shlichut even after he passes away. His inspiration and the fact itself that he is buried in Germany, in Hanover, this will give the inspiration for his family to continue in their shlichut. It's not only while he was alive, but the fact that his neshama and his body is buried in Hanover, in the place of the shlichut. Mrs. Wolf said that she is going to continue the Bet Chabad. And Rabbi Benny's children will continue the shlichut, the inspiration that Rabbi Benny began throughout his lifetime. And that is something which is so amazing, is so inspiring. Rabbi Benny, his underlining trait, character, was V'ahavta l'reacha kamocha ani Hashem. Love your fellow Jew as yourself, ani Hashem. The fact itself that he came to such a place, such a desolate, spiritually speaking, desolate place, was because Rabbi Benny cared for the people, the Jews that were there. And the fact that Rabbi Benny, right away, he chose this place. And he chose a place that he knew that it's going to be a challenge. And apparently his wife said afterwards that when they came to Hanover, they had no idea how much of a challenge it would be. But nevertheless, Rabbi Benny was chosen, Rabbi Benny will be buried. And I cannot refrain from mentioning that I was on a Zoom meeting at the time of the funeral on Sunday afternoon. And how emotional it was to see all of the Rebbe's shluchim from around Germany. And they were the ones who accompanied Rabbi Benny to his final resting place until Mashiach comes, and the Mashiach come immediately. And Rabbi Benny will rise together with all of the other Kedoshim and those that unfortunately have passed away due to the terrible coronavirus. And to see the Achdut, to see the unity amongst the Shluchim, to see the great Zechus, the great merit that Rabbi Benny had, that only Shluchim were the ones who brought him to his resting place, was something that just melted my heart. I cried like a baby on Sunday afternoon to watch Rabbi Benny unfortunately be interred in Germany. It's unfathomable. But he will be there. He will guard that people will be able to come to his kever. Anashim yuchlu l'amshich lavo l'kever sh'aravof. And to be able to continue the message that he lived. Masha Rav Benny, ha'derech sh'ayita lo, ech shehu haya chai, אנחנו צריכים לקחת את זה גם לאחרי זה שהוא נפטר. החיוך היפה שלו, his beautiful smile, באמת, that I can remember in yeshiva when we learned together. This is the smile, the underlining thread that brought him through his entire shlichut until his final day this past Friday night. לכן אני מבקש מכם ומכולנו שאנחנו נדגול במצווה הזו שוב יאהבת לרעך כמוך אני השם. שאפילו שזה קשה, אבל אם אנחנו נשים דגש על אני השם, זה יהיה והחי ייתן אל ליבו שאנחנו נמשיך את הדרך של הרב בני. If we can continue, we can work on ourselves, we can train ourselves and encourage ourselves to be able to be like Rabbi Benny, to adapt this such a special ruach and a midah and this mitzvah, v'ahavta l'reacha kamocha, because ani Hashem, we will see that in our circles as well, we will be able to bring Ahavat Yisrael in ways with people that we had never dreamed. Because why didn't we dream that we'd be able to unite with our friends? Because we thought that he did this, A, B, C. But the moment that we realized that we love them because of Ani Hashem, because Hashem is part of the partnership of this Ahavat Yisrael, V'ahavta l'reacha kamocha, then we know that even people that God forbid have not spoken in 10 or 20 years, or siblings that Hashem Yirachem that have not spoken in 20 or 30 years, that people will begin speaking again. Because they realize that really, like Aaron HaKohen, Ohev Shalom V'Rodev Shalom, we have to pursue peace. We cannot allow little nitty-gritty things to get between us. Because there's one thing that is the same with all of us, and that's Ani Hashem. HaNeshama sheyesh li v'lecha v'lach, zeh ma she'me'ached otanu. And we can bring this into practice. Sometimes it's hard. But Be'ezrat Hashem, we will be able to be la'atzliach. We will be successful in this mission. Aviyahavta l'orecha kamocha ani Hashem. Toda rabba lachem. Thank you so much. L'chaim. with your coffee or tea or whatever you have, and look very forward, Bezrat Hashem, Shavua Abba, B'Shah 9:30, Kabbalah Cafe. I look forward to seeing all of you, Bezrat Hashem, right here. Halavai, Shashem Yavir Refuah Le'olam. And we should be able to, Shenuchal Leshevet Biyachad, Be'emet, Be'Cafe, Be'ishi, Be'etva'adut. May we be able to sit together in a real cafe, a real Fabrengen. But in the meantime, L'chaim, L'chaim, Erev Shabbat Shalom. Thank you so much. Todah Rabbah. Thank you for your time. Kol Tov.